Surat Al-Mujadala. In the name of Allah, the Compassionate, the Merciful. Allah has indeed heard the words of the woman who pleaded with you against her husband and made her complaint to Allah, and Allah has heard what you said to each other. Allah hears all and sees all. Those of you who divorce their wives by Zahar should know that they are not their mothers. Their mothers are only those who gave birth to them. Surely the words they utter are absurd and false. Allah could punish them for this, but He forgave them. Surely Allah is all-pardoning, all-forgiving. Those who divorce their wives by Zahar, then wish to retract the words they uttered, shall have to free a slave before they touch each other. This is enjoined as a penalty for doing so. Allah is well aware of all your actions. He that has no slave shall fast 2 consecutive months before they touch each other. He that cannot fast shall feed 60 poor people. This is enjoined so that you may have faith in Allah and His Rasul. These are the limits set by Allah, and the violators shall have a painful punishment. Those who resist Allah and His Rasul shall be humiliated as were those before them. We have sent down clear revelations. The disbelievers shall have a humiliating punishment. On the day of judgment, Allah will raise them all back to life, then inform them about what they have done. Allah has kept full record of their deeds, even though they may have forgotten, for Allah is a witness over all things. Are you not aware that Allah knows all that is in the heavens and in the earth? It cannot be that 3 persons converse in secret and He is not the 4th of them, or 5 persons converse in secret and He is not the 6th of them. Whether fewer or more, wherever they may be, He is with them. Then on the day of resurrection, He will inform them of what they have done. Surely Allah has knowledge of all things. Have you not seen those who, though forbidden to hold secret counsels, persistently do what was forbidden? They hold secret counsels among themselves for sin, hostility, and disobedience to the Rasul. Yet, when they come to you, they greet you in words which Allah does not greet you with, and say to themselves, "Why does Allah not punish us for what we say?" Hell is enough for them. They shall burn in its flames. What an evil destination. O believers, when you confer together in private, do not talk about sin and hostility and disobedience to the Rasul, but to counsel about virtue and piety and fear Allah before whom you shall be brought together. Conspiring in secret is the work of Shaitan, who means to vex the believers, but he cannot harm them at all except as Allah permits. So in Allah let the believers put their trust. O believers, when you are asked to make room in your meetings, make room. Allah will make room for you in the hereafter, and if you are told to rise up, then rise up. Allah will raise to higher ranks those of you who have faith and knowledge. Allah is aware of all your actions. O believers, when you want to consult the Rasul in private, offer something in charity before your consultation. That is best and purest for you. But if you lack the means, know that Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. Do you hesitate to give out in charity before your private consultation with Him? If you cannot afford it, Allah will forgive you. So establish Salah and pay Zakah and obey Allah and His Rasul. Allah is well aware of all your actions. Have you not seen the ones who have befriended those who are under the wrath of Allah? They are neither on your side nor yet on theirs, and they knowingly swear to falsehood. Allah has prepared for them a severe punishment. Evil indeed is what they are doing. They use their oaths as shields and debar others from the way of Allah. They shall have a humiliating punishment. Neither their riches nor their sons shall avail them anything against Allah. They shall be the inmates of hell and live there forever. On the day when Allah will raise them all to life, they will swear to Him as they now swear to you, thinking that their oaths will help them. By no means. Surely they are the liars. Shaitan has gained possession of them and caused them to forget Allah's warning. They are the party of Shaitan. Beware. Surely it is the party of Shaitan that shall be the loser. Those who resist Allah and His Rasul will be among the most humiliated. Allah has decreed, it is I and my Rasuls who will most certainly prevail. Surely Allah is all-powerful, almighty. You will never find any people who believe in Allah in the last day on friendly terms with those who oppose Allah and His Rasul, even though they be their fathers, their sons, their brothers, or their relatives. It is they in whose hearts Allah has inscribed faith and has strengthened them with a spirit of His own. He will admit them to gardens beneath which rivers flow, to live therein forever. Allah will be well pleased with them, and they will be well pleased with Him. They are the party of Allah. Beware. Surely it is the party of Allah that will be successful. Surah Al-Hashr. In the name of Allah, the Compassionate, the Merciful. All that is in the heavens and the earth glorifies Allah, and He is the Almighty, the All-Wise. It is He who drove the disbelievers from among the people of the book out of their homes at the first banishment. You did not think that they would ever go out, and they thought that their fortresses would defend them from Allah. But the wrath of Allah came to them from where they never expected, which cast such terror into their hearts that they destroyed their homes by their own hands, as well as by the hands of the believers. So learn a lesson from this example, O people of insight. Had Allah not decreed exile for them, He would certainly have punished them in this world, and in the hereafter there shall be the punishment of the fire for them, because they set themselves up against Allah and His Rasul. And he that sets himself up against Allah should know that Allah is stern in retribution. Whatever palm trees you cut down or left them standing on their roots was by the leave of Allah, so that He might humiliate the transgressors. As for those spoils of theirs which Allah has bestowed on His Rasul, you spurred neither cavalry nor camelry to capture them. But Allah gives authority to His Rasuls over whom He pleases, for Allah has power over all things. Whatever spoils from the dwellers of the township Allah has bestowed on His Rasul shall belong to Allah, His Rasul, Rasul's relatives, and to the orphans, the needy, and the travelers in need, so that it may not become the property of the rich among you. Whatever the Rasul gives you, take it, and from whatever he forbids you, refrain from it. Fear Allah, for Allah is stern in retribution. A share of the spoils shall be given to the indigent muhajireen, who were driven out of their homes and their possessions, and are seeking Allah's grace and His good pleasure, and who want to help Allah and His Rasul. Such are indeed the true believers. A share of the spoils shall also be given to those who made their abode in Medina and believed even before the arrivals of the Muhajireen and loved those who migrated to them and entertained no desire in their hearts for things given to them and prefer those Muhajireen over themselves, even though they themselves are poor. In fact, those who are saved from the greediness of hearts are the ones who will achieve true success. And it is also for those who came after them and say, Our Rabb, forgive us and our brothers who embrace the faith before us, and do not leave any malice in our hearts towards the believers. Our Rabb, surely you are the kind, the merciful. Have you not observed the hypocrites? They say to their fellow unbelievers among the people of the book, If they drive you out, we will go with you. We will never obey anyone who seeks to harm you. If you are attacked, we will certainly help you. Allah bears witness that they are lying. If the people of the book are driven out, they will never go with them. Nor if the people of the book are attacked, will they help them. And even if they help them, they will turn their backs, leaving them with no help at all. In their hearts there is greater dread of you than of Allah, because they are a people devoid of understanding. They will never fight against you together except in fortified townships and from behind walls.